What does music mean?
Take 3 minutes.
That's a loaded question, because music, it takes on a lot of characteristics for me. I think music is for sure one of the essences of life. It's probably one of the oldest situations that human beings have been involved in. And not just human beings, other beings too. And it's also one of the things I think that probably brought some of the most joy to beings throughout our known world. It's been a method for many things to transpire and to happen, many different forms of growth, spiritually, economically, physically. It's a vibration that can bring about a lot of healing on various levels, emotionally, psychologically, physically. And it's something that I think beings can share, also regardless of where they come from. And so it's, I think the music itself is, in one sense, is always sort of safe, in a way, but when certain types of limited sort of attitudes and understandings get involved, it can take on a an aspect that can be very limiting to our awareness. Not so much the music itself, but the approach to it. And I feel that the music is something that's been given to us free, in a way it kind of it gets downloaded into our systems, And what the future holds, for music, I think, depends a lot on what we do now. Myself, I've been very fortunate to have had some great mentors, and to been in situations where I can say I've been able to spend time with artists that are very conscious, Sadiq being one of them, and people like Fred Anderson, and the drumming also, I would say Steve McCall was probably, he was a great artist that had a very strong effect upon me that I had a personal relationship with, and then many artists that were not from my per se born culture, but those that I met, from traveling, and some that I never met personally, but I was exposed to them through listening to them and reading about them, and that have been very influential, I would say, in kind of guiding my course in a way and putting me on a path that I feel has given me a great benefit. And I hope through that, maybe in some small way, I've been of some benefit, for others too. I mean, that's one of my greatest hopes and intentions, that what I do and what I do, what I'm allowed to do in conjunction with other, great artists too, it can be a benefit to beings everywhere in some way, because we're here for that, to be of service on many levels, many, many levels. And sometimes what we do, in the beginning, it kind of goes unseen, but certain seeds, get planted and they germinate, and God willing, they sprout later. But I think probably the importance of music is probably even greater now in the time in which we're living in, because we are, in some ways, on some levels, troubled times, you know, and artists in general, and I think musicians in particular, can be what Harry Belafonte called the gatekeepers of truth, and it's just truth, you know, not so much always methodologies, but truth, you know, and you know, methodologies can lead us to that, but the methodology itself is not, you know, the truth, but just, you know, artists, you know, I feel like I said, I think musicians in particular can be gatekeepers of that, you know, and bring help to continually manifest that energy that is always present, you know. Different cultures have different names for it, you know, different aspects of it. You know, we might call it Shango or Ogun, you know, we might call it Yesi Sogyal, Padma Sambhava, you know, we might call it the Holy Spirit, you know, we might call it Allah, you know, or saving grace, whatever different terminology is used in different languages. But to be able to continually, you know, recognize, you know, that, because that is something that's inherent, you know, in all human beings. You know, it's a self-generating, primordial. That thing is prior to all the other stuff and confusion. So, if we can continually, in some way, understand and tap into that, you know, reality, I think, you know, we'll have a chance.